The Outlaws is a 2017 South Korean action thriller film directed by Kang Yoon-sung and stars Ma Dong-seok, also known as Don Lee, Yoon Kye-siang, Jo Jae-yoon, and Gui Hwa Choi. The movie is based on the Chinese-Korean gang mop-up operation conducted by the Seoul police in 2004, and there have been no streaming platforms for this, but considering that the remake has come out in Z5, and that's one of the reasons why I decided to check out this film, and it's really entertaining. I had no idea that the events that led up to the actual operation was done in this way. I don't know if there's any truth to how the events actually took place. Some of it felt like, you know, like certain liberties were taken, especially the actual cause of the operation, like the meeting that led up to the operation. It was done in a very comedic way, and I don't know if that's true in real life. Don Lee is perfect in this film. He has this kind of normal everyman kind of a look, but he's trained in martial arts, I guess, but he's the only competent fighter. But the movie makes it a point and emphasizes on the common man aspect, as he's not this Superman level kind of person. He actually has his own weakness, he has his own flaws. He's not the perfect person, he's far from it. His jokes are really funny, especially in that brothel scene, I think. when he's caught, he just switches the situation. I'm like, oh man, you have to watch that movie. It's so funny, the jokes he makes and everything. And the events leading up to the climax was also great. It was very entertaining throughout, and it was just so fun watching these characters just, you know, just converse with each other. I would have watched the entire movie if it was just that itself. The villain is also very competent. He's very intimidating. If you have ever heard the phrase, looks can be deceiving, I think this is one of those movies that actually shows that. Because from the surface, like outside point of view, he looks like a normal guy with long hair. But it's when you see, when people interact with him, that you see his menacing side. I mean, the dude will chop off your hand if you don't pay the debt on time. And he will very much kill your boss without even flinching. So he just took out the boss of a rival gang in just like that. And all the others could do was just stand there and watch. He's that threatening to them. I wanted to know how they are going to deal with this. Like, are they going to kill the guy or are they just going to arrest him? They went with the arrest ride on this because they wanted to keep it real, I guess. But therein lies the problem, though. It's something that I noticed after watching the film. Like, I had some time to think about it. Is that the villain never actually goes after the hero. Like, he never goes after Don Lee. He just goes after only the other gangsters, which are only like secondary threats to him. Like, he knows the police is after him. They already caught one of his right-hand dudes. He never bothers to rescue him or anything, but the right-hand man, I guess, is so crazy that he doesn't find that suspicious. Like, his boss doesn't even care about him enough to get him out of jail. And I like the fact that even the movie emphasizes on, like, even the right-hand dudes having second thoughts about his leadership, but out of fear that he may kill them if they, you know, deny him, they still go along with it. Especially the second guy, after the first right hand dude's been caught, then the second henchman gets this fear, like, oh no, if I defy him, maybe he'll kill me, so I have no choice but to actually follow his orders now. There's that kind of tension in the film, and that goes throughout the film. It's just that the villain never bothered to go after the hero. I wanted to watch that. And most of the movie, the hero actually goes after the villain. Like, he wants to know where he is so that he can arrest him. And at first, he didn't really care about it that much because it was like small. But as the crimes he kept committing kept on increasing and raising the bar, especially, you know, beheading someone, or it's very serious, and he's not gonna have any of that shit, because the gangsters he usually deals with is like this low-key kind of people, like They keep the violence to a bare minimum, often resorting to something like what you see in a protest in India. So, but this guy, he knows he's serious and he takes all the necessary steps, down to the point that he outright says in a meeting, although it in a comedic way, that he will take down 25 of those gangsters, and they end up catching 30, including the leader. So he knows that he's the main threat right now. All the others are secondary, but he only goes after the secondary ones. He never bothers to do anything about the main dude, that the police guy. Up until the climax, I don't ever see them interact. Like, there are passing points, they meet up at a restaurant at some point. You could have had at least one minute fight scene there to emphasize the rivalry, but no, they decided to go another route to it. But yeah, I guess but overall it was a very entertaining package, and so I'm going to give The Outlaws a 7 out of 10. It's a very well-made Korean film, and I had very high expectations for Bharat, and it was completely demolished right in front of my eyes when I watched it in theater. So I'm gonna make it a point not to have any expectations for Rathe, but from the product I received, I'm very much satisfied with it, except for that just one part that he never cares about the villain to go after. He never cares about the hero to go after him, and that's the only kind of frustrating moment. I kept wanting for them to meet up and butt heads, but that doesn't happen until the very end, where he actually finds the dude. And but one thing I love about it is that there's this useless guy who's not very much adapt to be working in the field, but they don't kill him off. That's one of the fresh ideas I've seen, because most movies tend to kill off such characters, but they actually give him a desk job, and at the end he's just comfortable there. So I'm glad everyone gets something here. And if you're looking for a well-made action thriller film, then this will be right up your alley, and it's very humorous. If you're into this, I don't know, I think you like the humor well enough. Just have a watch and you'll enjoy it. If you're into Korean films, this is definitely a must watch. And that was my review of The Outlaws, Korean film. And let me know what you thought of the movie in the comments below. And if you like this video, please hit that like button, share this video with your friends, and hit that subscribe button, and hit that bell icon too, so that you'll be notified of my videos. Comment below what you loved about the movie, and let me know if I missed anything. And so I'll see you in the next movie, next video, which will be obviously of Rathe. You can see my level of excitement for that movie. God damn it. So, why always Korean, such good Korean films though? Anyways, I'll see you in that video. Bye. I've been flying from town to town, from London to Taiwan. I've been all around the globe trying to protect your soul.